Well, we're glad to have on the desk with us. That's Sipho Kekana. Thank you for your time on the SABC News Desk. It's the first time I'm seeing you this year, although under sad circumstances.
Yes.
Look, it's a huge loss for the sporting fraternity. How are people digesting the news and coming to terms with this right now? He's been called a gentleman, a unifier, both on and off the field.
Well, the truth is that he hasn't been well for some time. He's been in and out of hospital. He's been sick for a very long time now. But as you know, even when somebody's sick, no one can ever be prepared enough for death. So people are shocked about what has happened. It's a big loss to South African football. It's a big loss to the entire football fraternity. No one had expected that such a tender age, we would lose him. You remember that a few years back, we also lost the likes of John Schuster. So it is very sad that all these stars, and especially that crop of 1996 that won the African Cup of Nations. You remember we lost the likes of Sizwe Motaung. So all those players that one was looking forward to giving back to the youth to ensure that football is nurtured, football is taken forward in South Africa. We seem to be losing all those legends at a very, very young age, and that is very, very concerning. It is a sad day in South African football.
Look, I want to talk a little bit about his transition from being a player to an administrator. He did a lot of work when South Africa was lobbying to host the 2010 World Cup.
Yes.
A cause he held very close to his heart.
Yes, that was awesome. That was awesome. Obviously, they used the fact that this is one player that played in locally and was able to continue to represent South Africa in the English Premier League, playing for Leeds, and he also played. I mean, all over Europe, representing South Africa very well. You talk about Phil Masing, you talk about Lucas Radebe, you talk about Steve Compell, you talk about Shoes Monsieur. All those players, it's just a crop of players that managed to represent South Africa internationally with distinction. It is sad to see that I mean, today as I'm talking to you, we don't even have a single player that is playing in the English Premier League. So that goes to show the quality of this crop of players, and to be losing them while we were looking forward to getting more from them is actually very, very sad and a big loss. So obviously after his playing career, he did he had a very short stint with PJ Stars, and as you say, they used him in the 2010 FIFA World Cup
as an ambassador. Yes.
That was great. And look, however we look at it, South African football has lost the legend. And again, I mean, this one player, you'll understand that players also go through their ups and downs. He's one player that also he did big time in football, but also went through some very, very serious personal problems, especially financially. I'm raising this because this is one player that was able to come out to talk about the problems that he had personally, because you'll understand that a lot of players do go through financial problems and all sorts of problems after their playing career. Yes. But he went out encouraging young players, trying to motivate them, which I think was very, very plausible.
On the question of financial literacy and support for players in their personal lives and the psyche of players and how we keep our players healthy at that level, when he was playing still in his prime, did he have that financial support and personal support at club level already? Nowadays, I understand we do, but back then, was it there?
Nowadays, it's if it being there is still not locally. Locally, there's still a long way to go in terms of making sure that these players are able to manage their finances very well. So one of the things that he complained about was that, he said he was earning about 4,500 playing for Mamelodi Sundowns, and then suddenly he went on to play for Leeds, where he was getting 12,000 euros. So that was a huge difference, and he admitted that he had difficulties in terms of managing his own finances. So locally, we still have a long way to go. We still have players that are going through financial difficulties, and well, we're not going to talk about them, mention their names without them actually coming out to say so, and encourage those that the powers that be in football to make sure that those things are well taken care of.
He was also very active and very passionate about bringing former players, I read, back into the operations of football in the country. Something he was successful at to a large extent, because we now have a lot of former players who are coaches in the various regions as well.
Yes, you see, that is very, very key. We need more of that. We need more of that. That is why he will go down as one of our of the best legends. Best football people that we've ever had in this country. His goal in 1998, which sent Bafana Bafana to their first ever World Cup in France, will always be remembered. And when you hit it big in football like that, in a country like South Africa that struggles with football development, we need players like that who are able to come from playing in the in Europe, to come back, to go to grassroots, to go to the dusty grounds, and actually encourage those small boys to say, you know what, focus on what you do. And so for that, we really, really need to applaud him, and we hope that more and more of our legendary players will take lessons from that and continue to give back to football in the country.
Sipho Kekana, thank you for your time and joining us here from the second floor.
Thanks very much.
We'll see you again soon. Thank you for sharing your insights with us. Much appreciated.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, well, now.